Do you think it is possible to control someone's attention? Even more than that, what about predicting human behavior? I think those are interesting ideas, if you could. I mean, for me, it not would be the perfect superpower, actually kind of an evil way of approaching it. But for myself, in the past, I've spent the last 20 years studying human behavior from a rather unorthodox way, picking pockets. When we think of misdirection, we think of something as looking off to the side. When actually, as often the things that are in front of us that are the hardest things to see. The things that you look at every day that you are blinded to. For example, how many of you still have your cell phone on you right now? Great. Double check. Make sure you still have them on you. Now you can look at them probably a few times today, but I am going to ask you a question about them then. Without looking at your cell phone directly yet, can you remember the icon in the bottom right corner? Bring them up, check, and see how accurate you were. How did you do? Show of hands. Did we get it? Now that you are done looking at those, close them down because every phone has something in common. No matter how you organize the icons, you still have a clock on the front. So, without looking at your phone, what time is it? You just look at your clock, right? Now, I will ask you to take that a step further with a game of trust. Close your eyes. I realize I'm asking you to do that while you just heard there's a pickpocket in the room, but close your eyes. Now, you have been watching me for about 30 seconds. With your eyes closed, what am I wearing? Make your best guess. What color is my shirt? What colors are my shoes? Now, open your eyes. By a show of hands, where you right? That's interesting, isn't it? Some of us are a little bit more perceptive than others. It seems that way. But I have a different theory about that. That model of attention. They have fancy models of attention. Posner's Trinity model of attention. For me, I like to think of it very simple. Like a surveillance system. It's kind of like you have all these fancy sensors and inside your brain is a little security guard. For me, I like to call him Frank. So Frank is sitting at a desk. He's got all sorts of cool information in front of him. High-tech equipment, he's got cameras, he's got a little phone that he can pick up, listen to the ears. All these sense, all these perceptions. But attention is what steers your perceptions. It's what controls your reality. It is the gateway to the mind. If you don't attend to something, you can't be aware of it. But ironically, you can attend to something without being aware of it. That is why there is the cocktail effect. When you are in a party, you are having a conversation with someone, and yet you can recognize your name and you didn't even realize you were listening to that. So, for my job, I have to play with techniques to exploit this. To play with your attention as a limited resource. So, if I could control how you spend your attention, if I could maybe steal your attention through a distraction, Now, instead of doing it like misdirection and throwing it off to the side, instead, what I choose to focus on is Frank. To be able to play with the Frank inside your head, your little security guard, and get you instead of focusing on your external sense. Just to go internal for a second. So, if I ask you to access a memory, like, what is that? What just happened? Do you have a wallet? Do you have an American Express in your wallet? And when I do that, your friend turns around. He accepts the files. He has to rewind the tab. And what is interesting is he cannot rewind the tab at the same time that he is trying to process new data. Attention is a powerful thing. Like I said, it shifts your reality. So, I guess I'd like to pose that question to you. If you could control someone's attention, what will you do with it? Thank you.